Hello everyone, DonellHD here. Today I'm going to show you how to set up, configure, and install the Sony PlayStation emulator Duckstation on Launchbox. As per usual, I have my arcade folder here, and inside that folder I have my emulators folder, my Launchbox folder, and the ROMs folder where we're going to be keeping our ROMs. I left the link in the description below for everything that you're going to need to start playing games right away. All you have to do is go here and click on download. Alright, I've downloaded the PS1 Necessities file and I placed it here on my desktop. What we're going to do now is extract the contents of it into the emulators folder. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and run the emulator for the first time. So I'm going to go in my emulators folder, Duckstation, and I'm going to click on Duckstation QT-64-release-LTCG here. Once it loads up, it may ask you for an update. If it does, go ahead and say download and install. Once that's done, say OK, and it loads back up again. First thing it says is no games in supported formats were found. Please add a directory with games to begin. So if you already have your directory already, then just go ahead and click here to add game directory. I'm going to click add. Once again, it's on my desktop, arcade, ROMs folder. I'm going to select that folder here. And it asks, would you like to scan recursively? I usually just say yes. And now my games are here. Alright, our next step is to go to Settings, Display, and I have my renderer set as Direct 3D11, and I have my adapter, GTX 1660 Super. So depending on your video card, if you do have one here, then you will select it here. Now I'm going to go to Enhancements here, and right now I have it set to 6X for 1440p. You may have to increase or decrease this depending on your PC. I'm going to click close. Now I'm going to go to settings again. I'm going to click on controllers. And I'm going to select port 1 here where it says controller port 1 not connected. I'm going to select that. Drop the down arrow here and select analog controller. And I'm going to click on automatic mapping here. And I'm going to select SDL-0 controller Xbox One for Windows. Duckstation automatically remaps the controller for you, so I'm going to click close. Now I'm going to do one more thing here. I'm going to go to Settings, BIOS, and right here in the BIOS directory tab, direct it to the location you extracted your emulator to. In my case, it's located on my desktop, arcade, emulators, Duckstation, BIOS folder. Once you're done, you can go ahead and click close. And now we can close the emulator. Now it's time to set the emulator up in Launchbox. Alright, now that we're here in Launchbox, we're going to go to the top three lines at the top left corner here. I'm going to click Tools, Manage, Emulators. I'm going to click Add. We're going to name our emulator Duckstation. Now we're going to set our path. Once again, mine is on the desktop, Arcade, Emulators, Duckstation, and the Duckstation-QT-X64-Release-LTCG here. I'm going to go to Associated Platforms. And I'm going to make sure that Sony PlayStation is selected here, and I'm setting this as my default emulator. Now I'm going to go here to the running script area. And I left the script in the description below that if you require it, it allows you to escape out of the emulator by pressing the escape key. I'm going to paste this here. Then I'm going to click OK. And close. Now it's time to add our games. I'm going to be doing the drag and drop method here again. So I'm going to go down here to my folder here. And I'm going to go to my ROMs folder. And inside of this ROM folder, I'm using BenQ files. You can use BenQ and ISO and other various formats, but I'm using Q here. So I'm going to go up here to the search area, and I'm going to search for every game in here that has the extension .cue in it. All right, it found my three games. I'm going to simply drag these three into Launchbox like so. What type of games are you importing? ROM files. What platform are you importing games for? Make sure you say Sony PlayStation. Next, we're gonna go to Manually Configure Emulator. We're not using RetroArch, so we're gonna go to Manually Configure Emulator. Choose your emulator, make sure Duckstation is selected. Next, use files in their current location. Next, 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 make sure your games are spelled correctly, and then click Finish. Alright, now that they're imported, it's time to test out the games. Here is Mega Man Legends 2. And here's Gran Turismo. Thank you everyone for watching. If this video helped out at all, support the channel and drop a like and subscribe. I've created many tutorials for other platforms as well. Just follow the thumbnails on the screen. As always, I'm DonellHD, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.